Hey there, TikTakers! Today we'll be talking about epilepsy. Do you know anybody who suffers from this condition? Surely many of you have heard about people sometimes suffering from epileptic attacks. So let's see what this is all about. Epilepsy is a neurological disorder produced due to the increase of electric activity in the neurons of a particular part of the brain. Now, you might imagine that you have a bunch of high-voltage cables inside your brain, and it is kind of true, TikTakers. Figuratively speaking, of course. That abnormal electrical activity in the brain can make the person have convulsions or involuntary repetitive movements. This is because in that case, the brain will be sending wrong orders all over the body. And in case you don't know, convulsions are a kind of quick, erratic, and violent tremors experienced by the body. When someone who has epilepsy experiences convulsions and erratic movements, we say that the person is suffering an epileptic attack. For someone to be diagnosed with epilepsy, the person has to have had more than one epileptic attack during their life. And the causes of this disorder are not always known. In fact, in more than 70% of cases, the specialist cannot identify what produces it. Epilepsy can happen due to liver or kidney diseases, alcoholism, brain tumors, or even a hard hit on the head. Brain injuries during pregnancy or later on can also be common causes of epilepsy. But the truth is that almost anything which can alter the normal functioning of the human brain can cause epilepsy. Moreover, there can also be a hereditary predisposition to suffer from this condition. For instance, it is more likely for someone to suffer from epileptic attacks if their parents also suffered from them. People who have epilepsy tend to have their first attack when they are between 2 and 14 years old, although they can happen at any point in life. These conditions can affect everyone, regardless of sex, race, or region of origin. The diagnosis and treatment of this disorder have to come from a specialized physician, of course. And in many cases, medication-based treatments control very well the occurrence of epileptic attacks. However, around 20% of people with epilepsy don't respond well to medication-based treatments, and thus have to look for more specific methods to control their conditions, such as surgery or other procedures. It is also common for people with epilepsy to follow the ketogenic diet, a special diet rich in healthy fats, low in carbs, and also limited in calories. Other ways to prevent epileptic attacks also include sleeping well and reducing the person's stress levels. It is rare for someone to die from an epilepsy attack, although they could get injured due to the convulsions. Therefore, it is important to know what to do if someone you know ever suffers from an epilepsy attack. First, it's better to place the person on the floor. If we don't, the person could fall and get injured. Also, if the person is taking medications, maybe they are carrying emergency pills with them. So, if they tell you about the pills they should take, you should give it to them before an attack. Trying to give them the medicine during the crisis will not work because the digestive processes halt during the epileptic episode. If the person feels that they might be getting an attack soon, that's when you should give them the medicine. On the other hand, you also have to be very careful when dealing with a person with epilepsy. Because even being on the floor, the person could have more strength than usual and start hitting and kicking around. Because of this, it is also recommended that you set aside all nearby objects so that the person doesn't hit anything and gets hurt. And due to the violence of the movements, we also recommend that you put a pillow under their head to help avoid any head injuries. And even though at first we might think about taking the person to the hospital, it is best to wait for them to calm down first. However, in more severe cases, from the start of the epileptic episode, it's best to get in contact with a specialist who can guide you about how to proceed. And most importantly, do not leave alone the person suffering the attack, TikTakers. They can lose consciousness, and when they wake up, they could not remember what happened or where they are. Staying with them is fundamental, and knowing what to do in such situations is very important as well. That's why we love researching and talking about these topics. What do you think, TikTakers? Was this video interesting to you? If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to see more Draw My Life videos, subscribe to our channel. See you in the next episode!